You are turned on to Midwest Outdoors magazine. Since 1967, helping people enjoy the outdoors. Sponsored in part by Rapala Lures, Shakespeare Ugly Stick, America's strongest, most sensitive rod, Northwest Ontario, Canada, Abu Garcia, quality rods and reels for life. This week on Midwest Outdoors, houseboating and bass from Voyagers National Park, Kentucky Lake action from the Moors, and Devil's Lake walleye from North Dakota. It all starts right here, right now.
Decent one. Boy, he ate it good too, Scott.
First cast with the popper, wasn't it?
Yeah. Boom, you only got one hook in the bottom lip. Nice little smallie to start us out here in Voyagers National Park. Crane Lake, our annual family and friends trip to Voyagaire Houseboats. It's our first evening up the lake. I'm joined by my good friend Scott Walsh. Lives up here in northern Minnesota. He's here with his family as well and brought our houseboat up the lake. Got it parked. The kids are back swimming and playing, and we're out checking out the spots to see what they're biting on this year. We always come around mid-June with the family, Voyagaire Lodge and Houseboats, and in today's segment, we're gonna talk about fishing in northern Minnesota and talk about a great vacation idea for your family, Voyagaire Houseboats. It's a smallmouth bass. He's a tugging and a pulling.
Bigger than the last one.
Yeah, it's not bad, huh? He likes that bruised color. Come here, you. It's a respectable little fish. Guess we'll just keep catching them, huh, Scott?
Yep.
It was kind of off the backside of that. This kind of typical midsummer, early summer spot of these little sunken reefs. Close to the spawning bays, but just like points leading right to the main lake area. This is where they'll come after they're done spawning. Throwing a little plastic, soft plastic, little flutter worm like that. This rig wacky style on the end of the hook like that, or you can tech-spose it. It's like that. Wacky rigged is what caught that one. Simple presentation, just pitch it out there into the rocks and let it flutter down, and that's the result right there. Brian, so you're here at Voyagaire Houseboats with your family. Tell us who's joined you on this trip.
The four of us, Samantha, Hunter, my two kids, and my wife, Katie, and my parents, Jack and Nancy Teckel. We're from St. Cloud, Minnesota.
How did you hear about Voyagaire Lodge and Houseboats?
Actually, we heard about it from Midwest Outdoors, as a matter of fact. Uh-huh. Just watched it on TV, and we've been watching it for years. And
always wanted to go on this vacation.
Yeah, exactly. The fact that it's in Minnesota and it's not in a foreign country, mm-hmm. I love it. It's in my backyard, and I take advantage of
you're,
it.
You're so. Catching fish right off the shore here.
Oh, yeah, just before you pulled up. We had a fish on, lost it, but it's not the first one, right from shore. This was the first year we did the bed and breakfast, and wonderful. The breakfast was awesome. We had dinner at the lodge, just very relaxing. As soon as you pull in, they're unloading your truck, loading in the houseboat, you just sit back and relax. The staff is wonderful, the food is fantastic. Jim and Gretchen and their kids, I've never met such wonderful people in my life. They make you feel welcome.
And it's kind of neat to bring your cabin up the lake, have all your stuff with you up the lake, and you don't have to have those long commutes and long boat rides to the fishing spot.
It's wonderful. And we got the hot tub aboard, and just watch the stars at night. It kicks butt.
Well, I hope you're blessed with great weather, Brian. It's a great pleasure to meet you.
You bet.
A fan of Midwest Outdoors Television, and folks, you've heard it from the horse's mouth there. Voyagaire Lodge and Houseboats, a great place for a family vacation here in the Minnesota Northwoods. Tremendous amount of history in Voyagaire National Park and the Crane Lake area as well. And the rocks here behind me is what's called a blind pig. During the Prohibition era, you would come here by boat and put your money in the blind pig hole, and you would return the next day or 24 hours later, and you'd find yourself a little bottle of Schwab, a little whiskey or bourbon. And that's how you managed to keep yourself well lubricated in the North Woods during the Prohibition era. A houseboat vacation with family and friends creates memories that last a lifetime. If you'd like to start your own family memories here in northern Minnesota in Voyagaire National Park, you can call 1-800-88-BOATS or go to houseboatvacation.com for all the information you need to plan your trip here in northern Minnesota. Voyagaire Lodge and Houseboats, Jim and Gretchen Jansen, their family and their staff will take great care of you. I'm Roger Cormier with family and friends, and we'll be right back with more Midwest Outdoors.
Come catch a Crane Lake fish where the road ends and the adventure begins. Explore the incredible opportunities Crane Lake, Minnesota offers. Crane Lake, the gateway to the vast and unspoiled Voyagaire National Park. Start planning your Crane Lake, Minnesota adventure today. Call or log on to cranelaketv.com.
Hey, you remember when we were hanging out last night? You know, me, you, Gail.
That's my girl.
You guys are awesome. And then you went to bed.
I was tired.
You were super tired. And then it was just me and Gail.
Mm-hmm.
Alone.
What?
Oh, yeah!
It's all in the pause. New Shadow Wrap from Rapala.
What an awesome day. And I mean awesome just because this weather is perfect. It's ideal, especially when it's freezing and snowing up north where I come from. This is the perfect opportunity to come down and still catch some freshwater, open water fish. Hi, I'm Larry Ladowski with Midwest Outdoors, and today I am down in Kentucky Lake fishing from the Moores Resort. I'm fishing with Kahuna's Guide Service and his top guide, Chris Hicks. We were driving along, we saw this bay. Saw all these gulls that were just diving, and that's the first sign in the mornings. When you see that, you know they're after some bait fish. So what we're trying to find is what's after the bait fish. Stick with us, we're gonna have some fun and catch some fish. Ooh, there we go. Got him. Staying down. Feels heavy though, that's good. Ooh, it's a bass, it's a nice bass. Oh, stay down. Oh, pretty. Large, largey. Come here, buddy. Yes. Cool, and that's what matching the hatch does. You can see that Yozuri is right in its top. Taking those shad, and that's what you do too. You look for signs of that the lake tells you. Chris saw those seagulls just chomping on all that shad and said, there's gotta be fish munching on those things too. So, fat fish too, boy, he's eating. That's for sure. Show you exactly what we're looking at here. This is what the gulls are chasing, and this is what I'm throwing. I'm matching the forage pretty well here with this Yozuri 3D. It's a vibe bait. Looks like a little shad. It's a great exploratory bait, you know, especially when we're not right on top of the fish. We're basically trying to fan cast all around these seagulls and these bait piles. But it's got a great action to it. Terrific wobble. A lot of vibration. And with the 3D prism in there that Yozuri has, it's an awesome looking bait too. I mean, that matches the shad just perfectly.
So is this all one big flat here, Chris?
Well, this is one big creek. And the further you get back in these bays, the creeks have silted in over the years because this lake was impounded in the early 40s. But we're back here fishing on some just scattered brush piles on some flats, and then we're gonna work our way back out towards the mouth of the bay, and we're gonna get on some creek channel ledges and fish some brush piles there. You know, when you're fishing every day, we try to manage our fish and not fish the same stuff day after day after day, and you know, fish it one day and give it a couple days a break, let some fish get back in there and replenish the brush piles.
And your marker buoy there, will you throw it on a, You're not gonna throw it right on top of the...
No,
right.
I'm gonna throw it on the upwind side of the brush that's showing up right there. And then that way the wind won't blow me back into that mark and it won't get back in the motor.
That's a great tip.
And it It just gives me a reference point to where I need to get my boat with a trolling motor where everybody can be around that structure and everybody have the same opportunity to catch a fish.
That's a better one. This one's tugging a little nicer. There's a nice crappie. Yeah.
He's gonna be close, Larry. I'm gonna have to get my board out and check him. Don't know that he'll make it, but he is definitely big enough to check.
They gotta be 10 inches, and Chris
gotta
has
be
a nice
10.
Little frayed little board here.
I believe that he is gonna make it.
That's the top
yes,
right there?
Yep. Right there, right. He's on the money.
Perfect,
all right,
nice.
There we go.
You know, we're using a real easy presentation today, too. I'll show you. Got a 4-pound test, a bullet weight, slideable, and all the line is just tied to a snelled hook with a minnow. Just kind of setting it right above the brush piles. Great thing for kids, too. Kids, wives, families, you name it. That's what the nice thing about Kentucky Lake is that there's always something to catch. You can catch and eat. That's another good thing. You got white bass, you got crappie, you got catfish, bass, regular bass. There's just a variety of species down here. It's great fun for families. I mean, if you want to take the wife down, you got the guy's trip, whatever. And Moores is a terrific place to stay, too. They've got every type of boat imaginable that you can rent, from pontoons to fishing boats to jet skis. And then their lodging is first class, too. They've got a variety of that as well, from anywhere from cabins to a hotel. They've got a dock store right at the end of the dock that is complete with, you can get your fishing license there, you can get food, you can get t-shirts, anything you need to cook with. Then they also have an on-site restaurant. Excellent restaurant that overlooks the lake. The grounds are ideal. You got a sand beach, volleyball, kids play area. They even got a miniature golf. And one more nice thing about the Moores, they are always improving their resort. I think they just put up 5 new cabins. It's an ideal place. Well, you know what? We sure caught our variety today.
Fruit salad today, a little bit everything.
The fruit salad of Kentucky Lake. And if you want some of this action, you gotta come down for some Kentucky hospitality at the Moores. Just give them a call. Tell them you want some of that Kentucky Southern hospitality. I'm Larry Ladowski. I want to thank Chris Hicks for joining me today, as well as the Moores for putting us up. Midwest Outdoors is right back. We'll catch you later.
Thunderhook Fly-Ins offers the best fly-in and fishing accommodations anywhere in Northwest Ontario. Experience trophy walleye, northern pike, and brook trout fishing while enjoying our luxurious fly-in outposts or smooth rock camp. Visit thunderhook.com today. Canvas Craft, the leader in high-quality fabric products since 1977. We take pride in developing innovative solutions and pay critical attention to detail. We specialize in custom fabric products, including boat covers, tops, enclosures, curtains, and storage covers. Also, custom awnings, canopies, and shade structures. At Canvas Craft, we use the highest quality outdoor treated materials, guaranteeing a long-lasting top-quality product. Visit our new expanded Otsego, Minnesota location or call 888-428-4325.
Got a little nicer one here, the guys.
All right. Need a net?
Sure, if you'd like.
Yeah.
All right. Getting started on Devil's Lake. Aaron McQuoid with McQuoid Outdoors. Here we are fishing on Midwest Outdoors show, Devil's Lake. Just taking the guys out fishing, and we're going to catch a bunch of walleyes today.
Oh, fish on.
All right, what do we got? Another Devil's Lake walleye.
Devil's Lake, very fertile, lots of walleyes. 16, 17 incher. Lots of these in the lake. We'll catch 30, 40 of these every day, and just great eaters.
Another eater?
Yeah, another eater. He's mad now.
Another Devil's Lake eater. You're just looking for enjoyment. It's just there's a lot of fish out here to catch. One after another all day long. What do you got, Joel?
Yeah. All right.
A good walleye.
There we go. Another good eater. Just about on every color.
Yes.
Better one?
Nice and steady, nice and steady. Keep backing up a little bit. There we go.
Nice fish.
Well, all we're doing is just going up and down the gravel roads out here. Because Devil's Lake is flooded so much, it makes a lot of structure out here for people to fish. We just follow up and down the gravel roads, and there's just tons of these little fish. They flourish. They're sitting in the soft bottom on the sides in the road ditches. Then they'll come right up on top when they're ready to feed. So it's kind of like a food funnel. You sit right along that top edge of where the gravel is, and it makes it pretty easy fishing. What do you got there,
bud? I don't know, but it's mad now.
All right.
Oh, that's
here
a nice
go.
Fish. All right.
There's a fish. That's what we're looking for.
That's the kind.
This is why we come to Devil's Lake.
That's cool.
And we can use any technique that we're doing, whether you're pulling spinners or you're one of bottom bounce or you want a jig, you want a snap jig, anything that you like to do back home, you can do it here. And whether you're in July, August, dog days of August in so many lakes, we do so well out here. So if you get a chance, come out in July or August. That's the time to come.
Yeah, nicer fish.
That?
Yeah,
all right.
Nicer
good.
Fish. Oh, yeah.
I just showed you this one. I just lost this one.
Yeah, thank you. That's the North Dakota fish
that's
that I know.
That's North Dakota.
Yeah.
There's 600 rooms around the Devil's Lake area. Whether you want to stay in the Econo Lodge or the five-star hotels, there's motels, restaurants, lodges, all sorts of places around. If you're a camper, you can go camping.
There it goes.
Whether it's windy and you want to go to a protected marina so you can stay out of the wind for loading and unloading your boats, there's four protected harbors. There's landings on every shoreline. If there's north winds, you can always go to the south shorelines. If there's south shorelines, you go to the north shoreline. I mean, it's so easy to get away from the wind and hide. So many people think North Dakota is so windy and you need this big boat. You don't. Honestly, a 18-foot boat is plenty big to come out here and go fishing.
He don't like it either.
He man. Don't?
Oh, he don't like me.
Oh,
he
it's a pike. One of those things you just never know what you're going to get. One species that a lot of guys don't ever try to get is the pike, but we have some beautiful pike here in Devil's Lake. They're going to get up to about 25 pounds is what we can catch, up to that 20 to 25 pounds. This one obviously is not that, but these are the good eaters. You can catch them summer or winter all year round. We got him. All right. Just like that. Come on, buddy. Doing good.
Is he coming?
Doing good. He's coming. It's a walleye.
Is that a walleye?
This is the one.
Oh,
hey!
Another
there's a fish. That's what we're looking for. Folks, we've shown you what you can do out here, but this is what you really can do. This is what Devil's Lake is known for. There's a nice one. That's what we're looking for. Nice 23-incher. They're just hiding up and down these roads and rocks and different road beds and weed beds that are out here in the lake. You just keep pulling your spinners up and down, you'll catch these. So these are wonderful. Got another shaker, another head shaker. I'll need the net on this one too. Right after switching colors, the bead combos make a big difference as far as what colors in which order that they go in, as far as what size fish a lot of times. This was a hatchet blade on this one, and this just seems to be working for today. But you want to keep changing. If it's not working, change. Don't get stuck doing one particular thing as you're going up and down these railroad crossings and roads and that here in Devil's Lake.
While we're doing that, let's get
we should get doubles again.
Yeah,
now this is what, the third or fourth double?
I know.
All right, I'm ready. I'm ready. Fish in hand.
Oh, I got him.
Holy smokes. Aaron,
does this ever get old?
No. If you want to go out to Devil's Lake and you want to come out and see these, devilslakend.com, and you can come out here and have your own story to tell. Everything is on there, lodging, resorts, hotels, guide service. Look around, and you can come out and do this yourself. So from Midwest Outdoors, I'm Aaron.
Gary.
Joel.
And we'll be right back.
Take the helm of a Rainy Lake houseboat and explore over 200,000 acres of sky blue waters and majestic forests in Voyagers National Park. With 9 styles in our fleet, you'll find the perfect houseboat for a getaway with family, friends, or business associates. Experience world-class fishing on Rainy Lake with monster walleye, bass, pike, and more. Slow down, relax, and reconnect with family and friends amongst wildlife, towering pines, and ancient waterways. Call 1-800-554-9188 or visit rainylakehouseboats.com.
For anglers who want it all, the new HDS3, a revolutionary step forward in simultaneous chirp sonar and structure scan HD sonar imaging. Clearer views, faster interface, multi-touch screen, keypad operation, and total boat control. Plus, with versatile networking and go-free wireless sync of maps, software, and apps, HDS3 is the ultimate fish finding system. Wow. Find, navigate, dominate with Lowrance.
Good red dot sight like this OpMod Strike Fire is the easiest, fastest, and most versatile sighting device you can put on a firearm. It's unintimidating on this 10/22. It's great for new shooters. It's not heavy. It weighs only about 7 ounces. It has either a green or red dot, you choose. It's adjustable in 10 intensity settings, the lowest two being night vision compatible. It'll run for up to 600 hours on low setting. That same strike fire is ideal for handgun use, whether it's a large caliber handgun or a plinker like this 22. Again, it's not very heavy. It doesn't have any eye relief requirements, so short arm person or long arm person could use it just as easily. Where it really shines is on the AR platform. It comes with the cantilever mount, offering a lower 1/3 co-witness with your iron sights. It's great paired with this Vortex VMX 3T magnifier, so now you can go from a wide field of view and zero power to, with the flip of a switch, a 3-power magnified dot. The Vortex OpMod Strike Fire is also night vision compatible, and it has among the cleanest, roundest dots in any light conditions you can imagine. So if you're looking for a great quality red dot sight, consider the OpMod Strike Fire. It's excellent on a pistol, it's superb on a 22 rifle, and it really shines on the AR platform. To find out more about the OpMod Strike Fire, go to opticsplanet.com. I'm Steve Ledden with your Midwest Outdoors Tip of the Week.
Closed captioning of Midwest Outdoors, sponsored by Midwest Outdoors Magazine, on your newsstand now, and the all-new MidwestOutdoors.com, loaded with video, articles, and TV episodes.